In roof construction, roof area is a very important element, and on today's tutorial we want to look at how to calculate roof area for a gable roof. Welcome back again to my YouTube channel. My name is Christine, and if you're new here, kindly subscribe, share, and don't forget to leave a comment. Now we want to look at the roof area for a gable roof. And in this gable roof, we have the length. We are going to use the length and the width. We have the length, sorry, the width of the house and the length of the house. So those are the dimensions that we are going to use to get the roof area. And in that case, we are going to incorporate the eaves on this side of the width and on this side of the length for the overhang, that is on the side of the cable. So we are going to take the base area, that is the length, and the width of the house for us to be able to get the roof area. So if you can look at this structure, this plan here, we have the eaves that are striking outside, and then we have the rise, and then we have the run. So this method that we are going to use, we are going to use the rise and the run. We are not going to use the pitch, but if you want to use the pitch, for you to get the pitch is the rise divided by the run. You can be able to get your pitch. And then we have the roof angle. On this side we have the roof angle. Now let's see how we are going to proceed and calculate the roof area using what we have. So in this case, our house is of length 20 meters and the width is 10 meters and the rise, which is h, is 6 meters. Now we have we are going to include the eaves on this side, and then when we come to the length, you're also going to include the overhang that is protruding, that is from this point here up to this point here. And then we need to calculate the rafter length. The rafter length is a very important member, because the roof area that we need is this one, that one, and sorry, not down there, and that one. That is what we need. So we need to get the rafter length and the length that is the one that includes the overhang for us to be able to get the area, and then we multiply by the other side, because there are two sides. Now that we have the measurements or the dimension, let's proceed and see how we are going to get the rafter length. So we are going to take the width, we add the overhangs, we are going to take half the span, and then we add the eave, so us to get the new width, which is going to help us with use of the h to get the rafter length. Now let's proceed. So our eaves, these eaves here is 550 millimeters, and then on the other side of the length, the overhang on the gable is 600 millimeters. Now for us to get our new width, it's going to be our span plus the eaves. So our span was, sorry, our span was 10, so half the span is 5 meters, and then our eaves is 550, that is 0.55, giving us 5.55 meters. So that is our new width, that is half the span that way up to that point. This one now becomes 5.55 meters. Now we are going to use this half the span and the height here for us to be able to get this that length. So let's proceed. So our rafter length will be the square root of h squared plus the new width squared. So the height here was 6 meters squared plus the new width was 5.5 squared, so the square root of that gives us 8.14 meters. So our rafter length here is 8.14 meters. Now that we have the rafter length, we can proceed and get the area. So the length, so the new width now, that is the rafter length multiplied by the length of the roof, that is the length of the house, we include the overhangs for us to be able to get the rafter length. Now our length is 20 meters, the overhang we said is 600 millimeters, that is 0.6. So we have two of them, this side and the other side. So this is 600 and that is 600. So we are going to get the total length, that is 20 meters plus 2 into 0.6. That gives us 21.2 meters. So it means now from this side here up to that side is 21.2 meters. Now, therefore, the roof area will be the rafter length times the new length. So our rafter length was 8.14 multiplied by the new length, which is 21.2. Remember, there are two sides, this side and the other side. So we multiply that by 2, giving us 345.136 square meters. So guys, that is how we calculate the roof area for that gable. Thank you for your time. Thank you for your support. Until next time, bye-bye.